travels all over the world to create original and inspired content. So does her ability to empower and influence anyone who is willing to listen.
And so share with me maybe some of the high moments that you enjoy about your career and what you do.
I think this opportunity to be exposed to so many different walks of life from all around the globe is so fulfilling. You know, having conversations like in different cities around the world, that's been, I mean, you're probably the same, like you've traveled a lot as well. And I think that's, yeah, it's the people, right? It's
yeah.
What you learn through conversation and through like this assimilation into different cultures and different countries.
Yes,
like,
I'm highly stimulated when I see something new,
yeah,
taste something different.
Yeah.
With the people you meet and
yeah,
with what you do, everyone is like inspired. They attain to have a piece of what you experience, or inspired in different aspects of ambition or wanting to better themselves,
right,
be it through design or fashion. So yes, you influence a great body of people, mostly women.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's such a wonderful gift.
Yeah, but I think it's very sacred for me. I think women and empowerment and feminism, they're such buzzwords now. And it's something that's still very sacred to me. And I feel like the only way I can really influence or make a difference is really to live my life and to educate myself, and through conversation as well. I think that's so important. So for me, this platform that I have, it's special, and I would never want to take advantage of it. And there are people who listen to what I have to say. And when I do say something, I want it to be, you know, something that is substantial. You know, I've had women sort of approach me because they kind of felt the same way about me, especially in the context of having children and sort of the societal norms and pressures of a woman having children. And that's something that I'm very vocal about. In that sense, a lot of women have kind of reached out to me and be like, you know, thank you for voicing what I couldn't. And that's not to sort of give myself a pat on the back, but it's so beautiful that you can use this platform for influencing in a different way.
Yes. You've opened a different arena where, hello, it's okay.
Yeah.
Basically just a big hug is saying, it's okay.
Yeah.
No need to feel any weirdness or shame. Like, really, it's 2018.
No, exactly.
A woman can do so much great.
Yes.
She doesn't have to be placed in a box. Also with what you do, you showcase that, yes, I'm doing my greater good.
Yeah.
But so can you.
And I think at the end of the day as well, actions speak louder than words. And, you know, I think that too many people sometimes are quick to voice their opinions online, and it does become quite noisy. So at the end of the day, like, I would rather do what I do and then have that platform there as it exists, but it's not sort of the be all and end all.
Yeah. You honed in on your authenticity.
Yeah.
That's why you have your safe zone. So for the noise that comes in, it's all right. You got your headphones on when you need it.
Yeah, exactly. That's so true.
And that teaches many others also to put your headphones on when it's needed and don't join into the barrage that we have. So your authentic life still makes others think, oh, yes.
Yeah.
She got her stuff going on, man. I can do that too.
Yeah.
So this is our clincher question of the show.
Okay, hit me.
What is the definition of a woman of style to you?
Obviously, it's subjective, and it can assume a variety of identities, I guess. But for me, I think a woman of style is someone who is independent, who is hungry, is ambitious, is, you know, writing her own story on her own path. And I think because when that happens for women, it kind of manifests into something, you know, more external. And so I think it might sound cliche, but I really feel like, you know, a woman of style really starts internally.
Kim said it herself, women are interesting. We are mysterious, we are powerful, we are complex, cryptic, yes, paradoxical. And I love how she embraces her beauty with her intricacies and embraces the bold, brazen, brilliant woman that she is. She doesn't need a box because she'd break it, because her wings are ready to soar to stratospheric heights. Now that is a woman of style.
When you were a younger girl, like you're going to school and stuff, before like you establishing what you gravitate to when it comes to cuts, what were you rocking when you were going to school? Like,
pedal pushes. Did they ever come back?
I don't think they did. Pedal pushes
buried.
With like the ribbon on the side.
Yeah. The denim ones, the skin tight, like
the skinny jean pedal pushes, the daisy hat, the denim hat with the daisy, the fake daisy on the front. The socks over leggings. Oh, I can go on. I can go on. I can go on.
That might come back.
Yeah.
That could be your next like project.
Yeah.
I'm bringing the pedal pushes.
Bringing the
back.
Pedal pushes back.
These are the Kim Cam pedal pushes.
And but we need to rebrand them. We need to come up with something, a better name.
Thanks for letting us bombard your house.
Yeah, that was fun. Thanks for taking me for a ride.
Anytime you want.
Okay, amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll drive you around town.
Okay. Can I pick which car?
Sure.